Hey, I am Yale, and after making a bunch of 2D and 3D games, I was ready for the next step. Now, what is there beyond the third dimension? Well, the fourth dimension, of course. Get ready for some hyperdimensional travel. You may say, well, isn't the fourth dimension just time? You could look at it that way, but that is not what I mean. We all live in a three-dimensional world, where we can move forwards, backwards, left, right, up and down. Or in other words, along the X, Y and Z axis. Three perpendicular directions that can describe every place in our universe. What if there was a fourth axis that we could move along, perpendicular to all three other axes, a W axis, and define objects with those four-dimensional coordinates? Of course, we simple humans can't perceive these objects fully. But what we can do is look at some sort of 3D projection or section of those objects. There are a number of different ways to visualize these 4D objects. One very practical and useful way is to create a 3D section of a 4D shape, similar to what the upcoming game Miyakore does. To understand this, I had to get to the source of this concept, a short novel named Flatland. Flatland tells the story of a two-dimensional being trying to understand the third dimension. So you are living on a plane and are trying to grasp the concept of a 3D object. In this case, a sphere. The only thing we can see is a 2D section of that sphere, so a circle. When the sphere moves along the third dimension, all we can see is a growing and shrinking circle until it suddenly disappears. By layering all those sections, we can kind of understand what a 3D sphere could look like. From there, we can use the same way of thinking, but for the fourth dimension. So instead of taking a 2D section of a 3D object, we can take a 3D section of a 4D object. I could create a four-dimensional object and then set the W-axis to a certain value. The resulting shape would then be something that could be displayed with the three remaining axes. Now, how was I going to create this abstract geometry? And how was I even going to put it in a game, where all I have is a mathematical equation that defines its shape? If only I created something that does that exact same thing, but with some other kind of mathematical functions. I don't know, something like fractals? Oh yes, we are going to use raymarching again. For those of you who need a reminder or have never heard of raymarching, a raymarcher is a rendering method that draws shapes based on distances from the camera. Those distances are defined as formulas. So, what I had to do is define the objects as four-dimensional formulas and let the camera make a 3D section of those shapes at a certain W position. Ta-da! My first 4D object, a hypersphere. Well, it looks like a regular sphere, but the radius of the sphere is not just determined by the X, Y and Z direction. Now, there is a W axis as well. So, if we move our W position of the camera, we can see the sphere growing and shrinking, just like the 2D equivalent earlier, where the circle grows and shrinks when we move the sphere back and forth. Of course, none of this looks very exciting. It's just a round thing that grows and shrinks. The cool things start when we create other objects, like a hypercube, and rotate them as well. Because we are now creating 4D shapes, we certainly have three more rotational axes we can play with. The XW, YW, and ZW planes. Aha! This looks promising. Let's create some more shapes, like a duo cylinder, a 5-cell, and even 16-cell. Placing these elements in the scene wasn't very easy with my old raymarching script, so I gave it an update similar to how Sebastian did it in his video, where each object can be placed with an empty game object and a script attached to it. Of course, I had to give it a little upgrade to allow for the four-dimensional movement and rotation by defining those in the inspector. Now, placing objects was as easy as click and drag. Wonderful. Was one problem though. The rotation didn't seem to work the same way as it worked in the inspector. I dug into some Unity metacode and realized that the order in which the rotations are applied is very important. So, after switching those around, the rotation did what it had to do. I was getting excited and placed way too many objects in the scene, resulting in terrible frame rates. I hadn't even created a single level yet, and I was already pushing the game to its limits. So, I needed some way to optimize all of this. Then, I remembered that the performance of a raymarching is heavily dependent on the resolution of the game. If I could lower the resolution without having it look like a dirty low-res game, the game would work way better. That reminded me of a beautiful indie game called A Short Hike. That game was rendered at a very low resolution to get more of a pixelated look while still remaining a full 3D game. So, I just did the same thing. I let the camera render to a low-res render texture and set up a second camera it would look at the render texture. Bada bing, bada boom, 4 times the frame rate. This meant I had to keep everything very simple and clear. I had planned to use my little astronaut from one of my previous games, and he was in need of an upgrade to withstand traveling through the fourth dimension. A nice big neck brace. We wouldn't want to give him a whiplash. I added a cell shader so the colors would be better defined and more clear. I also created an invisible capsule that follows the player around to cast a shadow on the Ray March objects. To decorate the scene some more, I added some four-dimensional trees and rocks. The ground plane was given a waving pattern, controlled by a sine wave that was defined by all four axes, so moving the W axis would create some cool wavy effects. Because all the shapes were Ray Marched, I could very easily apply Boolean operators on them, like union, intersect, and subtract, allowing me to create more complex shapes, like floating islands, which were various objects intersecting with the 4D planes. This gave me a great idea for the gameplay. Let me explain. You play as a little astronaut who wants to get back to his ship. But there are of course numerous obstacles in the way. Luckily, there are these convenient buttons in place that let you turn certain objects into a different Boolean operator. So for example, that cube that is blocking your way could suddenly become a hole to get through. I created a button and an orb that you could place on that button. However, the orb also lives in the fourth dimension, so the button would only be active at certain W locations, which you can see above the slider. This created many opportunities for cool puzzles, like a doorway that would appear or a slope that would change shape and become its inverse. I created 8 levels in total, each of them building on the previous one, but all with the same goal of getting to your ship. You have to traverse the world and look for pathways through the fourth dimension by moving the slider. If you don't see anything, it's probably somewhere along the fourth dimension. I added a start and level select screen, and with that, the game was done. I released the game on itch.io, and you can play it now for free. I've also added the 4D framework on GitHub, so you can make your own 4-dimensional Boolean games. Be sure to like the video if you enjoyed this journey into the fourth dimension, and subscribe if you want to see more in the future. And I'll see you guys next time, where I will contemplate the meaning of life.